Yo, 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 what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Appreciate that, yeah. So, let's wait for a few people to come in. Already seen a few in here. Hey everyone, what's good? What's your question, Black Liar? I'm open for questions all the time. But yeah, I think we just start with a breakdown first, and I take questions as we go, maybe. Let me play the track one more time. I hope that's good, Hypertrap, copyright-wise. I mean, it's on your label, so. Why do you not make song in Pakistan? Because I live in Germany, maybe. I don't know. Do you mean lyric wise or what? Why do you not make song in Pakistan? You're ready. Why is my camera glitching out though? It's so weird. I hope that's better. Yeah. I'm gonna play the tune for you guys. Let's see. Let me know if the audio is fine. So that's the first drop. I'm really, really sorry that the vocals aren't the original ones, because somehow I didn't collect all and save, and I've lost the vocals, and I just redid them like 5 minutes ago. So yeah, they are not exactly like in the original tune, but yeah, other things in here are definitely still complete. The second drop is... Ouch. I definitely have to freeze something in here. But yeah, let's see. Let me freeze those subs real quick. My CPU is so bad. I really need to get a new PC. I'm saying that since like a year or so, but I'm procrastinating to get a new PC. Your neck is cracking. Sounds great. Cool. No, you make in India, so please also make a Pakistan song. I haven't made an Indian song, I think. Did I? But yeah, those kind of culture tracks are really, really cool. I love those theme-based ones. Black Liar, next time he'll make his song in Pakistan for sure, right? His song level. Oh man, that's slow. How are you guys doing, by the way? How was your week? If you have any questions, just drop them in here. I will get to them as soon as I can. Probably I'll be breaking down just from the beginning on. Let me see. Yeah. So that's frozen now. So yeah, either I start with a drop, because most of the time when I'm producing, I'm starting with writing the drop, then going backwards, writing the intro and the build. But yeah, we can definitely start from the intro too. Just let me know what you guys want to do. Let me try to play that second one. Yeah, that one is a bit hard. Let me see, is there something? Huh. We will get to that in the end. What's your favorite song from the Club EP? Analog plugins versus digital ones. You meaning plugins that emulate analog things, or like a Moog or something? To be honest, I'm using most of the time only digital stuff. I mean, analog stuff is a bit warmer, but yeah. I'm mainly using like Serum and those kind of things, Massive. So not really using a lot of analog plugins, I would say. Let me see if I can freeze anything else in here. Maybe that one. Let me freeze those two things here too. Maybe we are good then. But yeah, let me start from the intro. Sick setup. Thank you, man. Appreciate that. Yeah, I've got some new lights and stuff since the move. I've had like different variations in this room. First I was in the other corner, and I'm pretty happy here. Unfortunately, my studio monitors don't sound that great in my room, so I'm producing nowadays only on headphones, actually. But saludos desde Argentina. Saludos. ¿Cómo estás? How big are those screens? I think it's a 43-inch ultra-wide screen, but I have to look it up, actually. Cool. So yeah, let's start from the intro here. So the intro is actually just starting with those strings and then going into the Wheeze. Those strings are from a contact library. Let me open that up. And I'm really sorry, I haven't organized this project. So this is actually how I produced this. So let's see. So yeah, it's starting with... Yeah, so it's starting with those strings here. me just unfreeze this, and this is actually, well, this is session strings. Where do I have this? Yeah, here. So these are session strings, and it's this staccato one. So these are just like really sharp and have a big attack. And I've boosted it on the high end quite a bit, put a mid-side OTT on here and some echo. And this echo is really giving it that ambience feeling because it's a ping pong one. So it's really going back and forth on your ears, and that's kind of giving a great ambience already. And then just some more boosting on the, and some compression on the volume here. Let me freeze that back. Yeah, note-wise, it's pretty simple actually. It's two notes in the beginning. Yeah, and then just a little contour melody here. And I think most of the times people overcomplicate melodies. So I try to come up with something really, really simple that sticks to the head. So yeah, this is why I only have like a few notes. This song is in D sharp, so I'm starting on a D sharp. Let me freeze that back. These strings are real fire. Thank you. I love that sound. Yeah, by the way, I'm posting my link tree here. Is that the right link? Let me see. I hope that works. Yeah, you can follow me here on all my socials. Let me freeze that back down. Why is it not freezing? There we go. Okay. Next up, I have this ambience down here, which is just like some weird airy background ambience that's just filling up everything. And I have quite a few ambient sounds in here actually. So I have this one, the earth one. I have another one that's coming up in the later part here. That's kind of giving it a weird feeling, but it's kind of giving it like a more human feeling because these are vocals. So yeah, then we have some clock ticking going on. And yeah, that's for the ambient stuff. Yes, then on the next part, there are some more strings coming in. I think this sounds really cool. I've actually forgot that I made this. So these are just some more contact libraries. We have a flute going on, and I've made a little instrument rack to get like a stack. So we have those flutes, and I'm using the pitch plugin from the pitch MIDI effect from Ableton, so I can have different octaves playing on the same sound. So we have this flute, and we have this bassoon. And together they sound like this. I think they are actually from the woodwind symphony. Let me see if this is the same. Yeah. So it's basically from the same bank. Just a bassoon and the flute, and they're playing on different octaves. So the lower bassoon one is just like really low register, and the flute is playing up high, and they're getting compressed together with a mid-side OTT again. Same processing basically, the echo and the glue compressor, and they're just playing a different Yeah, and together they, yeah, really complement each other. Next up, we have some more strings, I think. Let me see. Oh yeah, this is interesting. So for this one, I used a signal. Let me see if I actually have that one still. Yeah, so this is a plugin by Output called Signal. Let me get rid of this. How do we actually get rid of the mixer here? No. Close. Nope. If anyone knows how I get rid of that little mixer thing here, I think it's somewhere here. Keyboard master? No. Browser info? No. We almost got it. We almost got it. Keyboard? No. Damn. Outputs. There we go. Okay. So this is just a preset from Signal, which is really, really cool because it has like a lot of movement in it. It's an app kind of thing. And I have a pan man behind it just to give it some more movement. So yeah, this is giving a nice feeling to this. Let's continue. We have some more context going on. So you see there's a lot of layering going on, which is really giving it that wide, big feeling. So a lot of human elements in here, like choirs and stuff. And you actually can't really hear this on its own. So, but if I get rid of it, it's really. It's really filling up like the whole frequency spectrum and making it big and wide. So this one is another output one called Exhale. And I think it's just some preset. Yeah, it's just another preset in here. And it's, yeah, sounding beautiful. I'm pretty sure I haven't touched like a lot in here. Maybe I changed something up with the tone. Or maybe with the samples in the engine here, but yeah, I think most of it is how it came. Let me freeze that back. If you guys have any questions about this, just let me know. And yeah, mixing wise, I'm just pretty much leveling a lot of this. So you see, I don't even have a EQ on here. Sorry about that. But yeah, a lot of leveling. And then, yeah, one of my signature things, I'm using this Tina Jo cello. I love to use those with in combination with a wheeze or some kind of a low register thing. And yeah, for this one I have some gliding notes going on, so you can see they are kind of going into each other, so we get like a little glide going on, which just sounds a little bit more natural. And this is from the Tina Jo artist series here, and it's the Legato one. Yeah, and it just sounds great out of the box. You can play it even an octave above and it still sounds really awesome. Yeah, let's freeze that back. Nice color coding, thank you. Yeah, I'm really into this kind of thing, to have everything looking kind of nice, because yeah, you spend a lot of time in your DAW. And have you used any glide in that bass though? You're talking in this one? I think let me see. No, I haven't in this one, if you're talking about this one, but yeah, I just feel with the, especially with the Tina Jo stuff, if you don't have those glides, it just sounds really, really unnatural. Let me play that. So you can hear it's like kind of it has its own release, and then the other sound starts really delayed, and I think that just doesn't sound that great. So yeah. So next up, I have an impact coming in here for this transition, which is pretty subtle actually. Yeah, in here there are the chants, which I think I recorded with my phone or something. They sound a bit weird actually. I don't know if there is some setting wrong. Let me see. D sharp minor, that looks... Organization is key, definitely, yeah. I'm starting every track with a template, so I don't have to organize myself a lot. Let me actually... Okay. Yeah, they kind of sound a bit weird. Oh, I don't know. Yeah, I think there's another bass going on. I'm going to show you the re-space here in a second. What is it saying? It's saying get em all with, because that's like the pre-drop. Get em all with. And yeah, it's really, really delayed and reverbed out. It's just another ambience element. Get em all with. And yeah, here are the chants saying the same thing, or I think they just say get. And you can see I'm kind of playing with the panning here a bit. I think they should be hard panned. And yeah, I'm sorry, they sound kind of a bit different to the original because I had to re-record it. But yeah, let's go into this re-space that's playing everything together. And yeah, this is what I talked about, especially with the cello. It sounds really, really awesome. And yeah, let's go into this Wii space. So let's break this down. So I have a little rack in here, which is just divided into a little sub thing, which is just a clean sine wave, which is going out of serum. And I have another one that's playing only the upper harmonics here. I think it's just a saw wave. Let me see. Yeah, it's a saw wave, pretty detuned. 8 voices. And you can see I'm actually automating the... so I have a macro setup on the cutoff, and this macro I think is an auxiliary source for this little LFO. So let me see in the matrix here. Yeah, this is the auxiliary source. So when I turn this macro up, the LFO is basically applied onto this filter, and this is giving it this opening effect here. Yeah, and I think I'm automating this. No, I'm not even automating it. Yeah, I think I have to. I have, yeah, on these higher parts, I'm automating I'm automating that one up. And yeah, it's a pretty simple patch. You see, it's only a saw wave, only a low pass. And I'm cutting off the low end on this just to don't get like a lot of phasing in here. After that, I have this ozone imager going on, which is just giving it some more width and making sure like my low end isn't phasing. After that, I have a little glue compressor and a multi-band dynamic, which is, yeah, just leveling everything out a little bit. And I think this auto filter isn't even doing anything we hear, but yeah, together they sound pretty awesome. And yeah, this is basically the first part of the intro. And then I just keep building, like adding other stuff on it, making it more interesting. So some drums come in here. And another arp is coming in here. So this little, there is a piano going on, which is not playing at all, cool. Then there is this little, yeah, this little thing going on here. Which is kind of playing the same melody, but a little bit different. Let me see what this is. Probably something pretty simple too. Yeah, it's just a sine wave playing really, really high, detuned, a saw wave playing really high. And the LFO is applied to the level and the cutoff here. Then we have another high pass going on. Some hyper dimension to make it really, really wide, which is weird because the size is really, really up, but I wanted it just to be like really, really wide and really spread it. So you can see without this, this is kind of giving it like a delay feeling too. Then I have some multiband going on, some delay and reverb. Yeah, post-processing is basically the same, some mid-side OTT, some compression, some EQing. Cool, and I think, yeah, other than that, there's just a little white noise rising up here at the end, just to make it better. And yeah, I have this little filter rack going on here, which is just doing a low pass, a high pass and a washout at the same. Which is pretty subtle actually, it's not doing a lot. Yeah, other than that, there are these drums coming in here. And these are, let me see. So I have a clap going on, a remedy clap. I actually have no idea why I have those in sampler. Usually I just use audio, but yeah, I don't know. Then I have some loops going on. Cymatics loop, cashmere loop. Another tambourine loop and another loop. Yeah, and together they give a lot of, yeah, fullness. Especially the tambourines, I've panned one to the right, one to the left, and these are giving it like a good stereo field. I mean, these are pretty subtle, but yeah, they add up to each other. So yeah, let's go into the build-up. So the build-up is, what's going on the build-up? I actually take out all the orchestral elements and I have a new bass coming up. So So the transition is done by using a little downlifter here and this white noise thing. And here's another sweep. And yeah, then there's an alarm going on. I have a visor in the background, which is pretty subtle at the beginning, but yeah, starts to get bigger. And there's another visor coming up here. Cool, then I have a Wii space probably. Oh no, this is actually a visor I made myself. Let me see. So this is pretty simple. So the first LFO is just giving it that movement here. Then we have two saws going on, one lower saw and one higher saw. I'm modulating the coarse pitch here. So this is giving it a lot of movement. And the other one is just a rising pitch for the other saw. And yeah, they are on the same weight. Just some hyperdimension again, some compression, reverb. Then next up, we have that little bass thing going on. And I actually referenced a Kaiwachi track for this part here. So yeah, he had that dun 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 dun, and I kind of mimicked it. So I tried to make something like this because I really liked that build up in this track. And yeah, this is a pretty weird patch. I'm using a saw wave being FM'd by a solid phase. I don't even know where this is. Let me see. Maybe in spectral? Yeah, in spectral solid phase. And yeah, this is a fifth. I have the FM on, but I'm also given the original tone from it, so it's not only using being used for FM, but also giving it some extra tone on top. And yeah, it's a pretty staccato sound, so I'm not having like sustain or release really going on. It's just like cutting off immediately. And then I have a sub going on. Downsample, which is giving it a lot of the tone. And I have the delay going on. Yo, Minimuse, what's going on, brother? No worries at all. You can definitely rewatch it later. So yeah. Yeah, this is the little rise bass here. At the end I'm just automating the pitch up. And a frequency shifter, so it's actually double rising. For the post-processing, I just have an OTT on here and a saturator and some minor EQing. And yeah, the vocals start to come in a bit pronounced. Yeah, I think that's like mainly it for the intro. Hybrid Trap is my life. Yeah, mine too. I'm fucking loving Hybrid Trap. Then I have something else going on here. Yeah, just another few visors here, which is giving it some more ambience. What is this? Oh yeah, and the resample drop coming in here. Ouch. Sorry, my CPU is really cracking out. Lol. Online classes and my stream simultaneously. That's crazy. By the way, guys, please make sure to follow me on my recording time has reached. I'm not recording. What is it saying? Yeah, please make sure to follow me on my YouTube channel too. I think a link is in the description. I'm doing streams like at least once a week and trying to upload a few more videos to you and stuff. Also follow me on Twitch and all that good shit. So yeah, I'm doing a lot of production stuff and really appreciate that. So yeah, let's do that little plug thing. So for the drop, let's continue with the drop. So yeah, so drop wise, if you guys saw some of my videos, some of my breakdowns, or some of my streams, you know I'm working a lot in audio. So I tend to do sound design sessions and reuse those sounds, and this is actually what I did here. So yeah, let's see. First of all, let's hear the drums. Yeah, so I have this super, super fat kick in here, which is, yeah, I really overused that one, so I'm not using that anymore, but yeah, this is the kick. It's basically a kick, just super, super distorted and a lot of saturation, EQ and glue compression to make it that fat. And it's really sticking out like hell in the mix. What is that audio to sound goes silly? What do you mean? For the snare, I have this snare, which I overused a lot too. Which is basically the same process. That audio to sound goes silly. Yeah, so it's just this snare. YouTube, Instagram. Let's see. So yeah, I have those drums coming up here. Just some minor EQing because they are already really, really layered. And then I have this little belly thing underneath with the snare. Yeah, I'm actually doing a lot of I'm planning a lot of more content in the on the Instagram channel and stuff. So yeah. So hopefully my Instagram will look a bit better soon. Yeah, so the drums together with the sub sound like this. And by the way, you can see I'm really, really clipping a lot in this track. And this is what I do for most of my tracks. So I don't have anything on the master that's really affecting the sound. So yeah, it's I'm just clipping like hell and then exporting it like this. For my sidechain, I'm using a Chain Shaper here, which is a Max for Life device, which I can't recommend enough. I will do a YouTube video on this too, so I'm not going into the sidechain too much here. Yeah, let's go into the sub. So yeah, first of all, we have that little, where is it actually? That little sub drop going on, which is just hip hop sub bass, which is a preset from Live 10. I'm using a pitch bend here. A kick tight to make it a bit fatter and a lot of distortion probably. Let's see. Yeah, so the zero square, which is actually just turning a sine wave into, it was that purple clip audio too. Let me see in a second. Which is turning the sine wave almost into a square wave. You can see this is the shape. And yeah, then some EQing and a little bubble wack, which is giving it that movement. So this is how it sounds normally. And this is just an auto pan. So that purple clip, audio 2. Oh, okay, yeah, this is a resample from the drop, actually. So I'm introducing the drop melody in the build-up here. So this is just a straight resample from the drop here. So this part here. And I just took it, resampled it, and faded it in a little bit. Yeah, then for the actually sub, let's see. I'm having a few layers here, so I have one layer that is just playing the bounce thingy, and it's mainly just okay, this one is pretty weird. Well, let me figure that out. So it's like a rounded or a squarey, yeah, kind of a squarey sine wave. So yeah, we have two different wave tables going on. One is just a sine wave and one is with a few harmonics. And yeah, I've made that into a wave table and I actually turned it all the way to the right. So it's, yeah, a pretty weird looking wave. But it's, yeah, given a lot of those harmonics compared to the just a sine wave. Let me, yeah, use that. So this would be only the sine wave. And yeah, this is how it sounds when I added all those harmonics on top. Yeah, there's no processing on here. I'm just having a little pitch envelope going on, which is giving it that bounce. Let me remove that. Yeah, so this is giving it a lot of the tone. Yeah, other than that, just some EQing, boosting some of those harmonics back up, and some glue compression, which is giving it some more crunch. Then there is a high layer, which is just the same patch with an erosion on top and cutting out all the low end. Then there is an ozone imager, which is giving it some width. Then there is this super distorted layer, which is a trash true, basically the same patch with a trash true preset. Not a preset, it's the mirror overdrive. I really cranked this wave shaping here. Boosted a little bit of the top end, made it wide again. Yeah, so these images giving it actually a lot of the tone. So it's really, really widening that top end. This is what I like to do a lot for my layers. Yeah, and then we have this super, super weird layer here, which is kind of the same patch with another ozone preset. It's called Bolt Fuzz Leader. And yeah, I think it's mainly because of the convolve here. It's super, super weird. Yeah, and a crunchy taco thing. And yeah, I've again cut out all the low end here, made it wide. Speakers go wet, wet, wet. Yeah. And yeah, I just use a little envelope follower to get rid of those tails. So otherwise it would sound like this. It's not that sharp, and with that, it's just following nicely how the sub is playing. And yeah, together with the drums again, it sounds like this. And yeah, it's always sounding super, super fat. And this is what I try to achieve with my mixdowns. So only the snares and only the drums and the sub actually makes a lot of the foundation. So this needs to sound really, really crispy on its own. Yeah, let's get into the fun part, which is actually not that funny because, like I said, we sampled a lot of this stuff. And I probably can't show you how I made this initially, but yeah, I'm going through this. So I've had a sound design session where I made some super weird sounds. Show in browser. Yeah, so yeah, these are basically the lead sounds I've made. Yeah, and you can see I used some of those in here. So these are basically just some different sounding ones. And I have a reverb throw going on at the end. And these are all going into the same processing. So I have a little EQ going on, cutting out all the low end. Then I have a phaser, which is pretty much not doing a lot. And a chorus, which is, again, not doing a lot. Yeah, Trash Jew is really, really good. And you can get it on sale for like $15 or something like that. Then I have a mid-side OTT just to make it big and loud. Glue compressor and yeah, the throw at the end. And yeah, then it's just a lot of playing with different sounds. So I have this one going on, which is the main sound, I would say. This is how it sounds originally. So it's a bit longer. I've shortened it and took out all the low end, added a compressed room reverb to make it really wide and reverby. Then there is this other lead going on, which sounds like this. Yeah, this basically. Again, took out all the low end here. And then it's just playing with a lot of rhythms till you find the right thing. So I think this really stays in your head somehow, like. It's really, really simple, but it's sticking in your head because of the simplicity. And it's like a good call and response. So it's doing one pattern and then repeating another one. And yeah, this one is just dragged out this time. And these again are from the same sound design session, just some other sounds. And I really don't have a lot of processing on here because I already made those sounds really wide and thick and sounding good. And for that second part, I think so I'm just playing a bit with the pitch here. So this next one is two semitones down, and these are two semitones down too. Yeah, here's another little sound I've made. By the way, what about your sample pack? Yeah, hopefully releasing it this weekend. There was still some delay on there, but it's coming sooner than later. So it's really, really huge. Yeah, this is a sample pack, but I will do another video about that probably. We should do a Halloween sample pack together. Yeah, we can do that, definitely. By the way, guys, I don't know if you saw it, but below in the description, I actually have a free sample pack for you guys, which is actually a collection of some of the sounds from some of my best tracks. I think from Only You and Motherfucking Drop It. Yeah, it's a really, really cool pack, and you can get it for free below. So make sure to grab this. Yeah, other than that, in the drop, I have a lot of not a lot, but a few effects going on. So this is the effect section here. So these are just some really weird. So some reverse sounds, some percussions. And yeah, these are really giving it some movement other than just the sound. So if I deactivate all these, you can see it's really doing a lot actually. Yeah, and if I activate those. Yeah, you can see it's just giving a lot of movement and a lot of vibes. Something cooking, I guess. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, for the second part, there are some more fills coming up. Let's see. Yeah, these are just some different sounds. Then we go straight into another build-up. See, yeah, I think the second drop is really, really hard on my CPU, and I don't really know why. So I try to break that down as good as I can. Yeah, so there's a lot more going on top of the normal drums. I have a lot of percussions going on. Which are just some wides, some hi-hats, some shakers. And you can see they're coming in and going out. I just have that little muter going on, which just mutes the sound. Yeah, other than that, there is this new sound coming in, which is, let me see. Awesome, yeah. I think, do I have something in here? Yeah, so I think I've made a resampling session from this little sound here. Actually, it's something I can show you, so let's see. Yeah, it's a super, super easy sound, just a saw wave with some reverb filter that's being automated. And this is actually in one of my upcoming packs too, I think. Yeah, I have no idea. Probably in some of that one. So yeah, when I'm releasing my sample pack, you guys have the option to get this little cool Serum preset pack too. I think these are not the sounds out of the pack, but I will definitely do a pack with those kind of. Yeah, and I think I just resampled that somehow and post-processed it even more. Yeah, so cutting out all the low end, some mid-side OTT, some frequency shifting, a lot of EQing actually on this. Ouch, sorry about that. And yeah, just made it a bit bigger and yeah, made another rhythm with it. So I resampled that initial idea. Oh, sorry about that. I have to freeze it again. But yeah, so you can see I'm doing a kind of different pattern than what I had originally. In here. Yeah, so most of the times it's just a super simple like one hit with one note, but I try to do some variations in here every now and then. And yeah, for the second part here, I think this is just, yeah, bumped down an octave. And there's a lot of backend stuff going on here too. So these, I have actually no idea why I processed that so weirdly. So yeah, it's pretty plucky here. I think it's due to the fact that I re-recorded it, that it sounds so weird now. Yeah, for the last part here, there's this siren going on, this little alarm thing again. And I did something really, really interesting here. I kind of followed the pattern I have with the and I did that by using the auto pan, put that to the saw mode, and using the shape to really make it really plucky. And yeah, then I automated the amount and the weight here to make it kind of fit with the other sounds in the environment. You can't access the link to the pack. Let me see. I think it should work though. It's sending you to my messenger. So yeah, make sure maybe to connect yourself to Facebook or something like that. And yeah, for the other part, I have it an octave down actually. And yeah, it's that downlifting part. And I think I even have another sub going on here. Let's see. So yeah, instead of having it that that plucky sub, it's, I think it's the same processing, but just not with a cutting envelope. So yeah, we have it steady. And it's super weird, but... other than that, there's a lot of, yeah, chants going on. Yeah, please make sure to like the video, to share the video with your friends and stuff. Comment as much as you can. Yeah. So let's see, what else do we got? Let me go back into the... any questions on these drops, by the way? Just... if you have any questions, just write them in the chat and I try my best to answer them. Yeah, the breakdown is basically almost the same like the intro. I think I just added some more impacts and stuff in here. So downlift some impacts. And yeah, I think it's basically almost the same. What is this? So this seems to be like a little glitch session inside of here. I have no idea why. I think this is for the third drop, but let's see. Shit! Get Yeah, so going into some kind of fauna flora-ish pattern here, which is really interesting. So I've did like a little fake thing. So no sub, or only like the sub for the first little hit, and then a tuba fake out thing. Yeah, and this pattern is kind of weird, but let's see what I did here. So I have some counter kicks going on here. Some claps underneath, some loops and some whistles. So it's basically the same pattern as I did in the first drop, but added some more stuff to make it more interesting. Yeah, and it's a bit faster. So this is with the counter kick. And this is done a lot in, for example, G House, where you have those counter kicks, and yeah, I don't know how I came up with that. And some claps underneath, a tambourine. And the whistle. Which is kind of funny. I think other, like the pattern is, or the rest of this drop is probably like almost the same. I'm pretty sure I haven't done like too much to it. Yeah, and then just going back into the normal thing here. And yeah. Then we have the outro, which is basically the intro combined with the drop drum. Damn. Do you like the first or second drop more? I think I like the first one better, but how do you layer everything and don't lose any texture? Back to the first question though, I feel like both drops are really, really different. So especially like this drop. But I think I like the first drop a bit better, but yeah, this is just like my style of things. How do you layer everything and don't lose any texture? Yeah, this is actually a hard question. Yeah, it really has to do a lot with how you work, how you mix down your stuff. You can see I'm not having like a lot of post-processing on everything because these sounds are already pretty processed. But I think the key element here is to take out the low end when you have another sub going on. And you can see I have everything running through a bus, so they get a process together, which is giving it a lot of that cohesiveness, I think. And yeah, you can see I don't have like 200 sounds at once playing over each other, at least for the first round. So it's really only like the main elements, the drums, the sub, and those little bass sounds. And yeah, the other stuff is pretty much in the background, only adding like some effects to it. But you can see only one sound at a time is playing. And I think that's a lot to the mix down. Other than that, yeah, and the second drop is a bit crazier, but you can see still here, there is only like this main thing playing and the background stuff. I mean, it sounds like there's a lot going on, but it really isn't, other than the alarm thing here. Yeah, and all those shans and stuff, but yeah, try to think about your mix down in importance. So you have not playing like tons of stuff in the main foreground. You just have like a few things really sticking up, and the rest is just like the foundation, like the background. Man, when the kick comes in and the sub goes down, that's the most fav part for me. Every time I hear, I get goosebumps. Yeah, you're talking about the first initial hit. That, yeah, that's really, really cool. I love that too. Yeah, Aaron, I hope that kind of answers the question. Yeah, it's kind of hard to, and it takes a lot of practice and a lot of trial and error and a lot of failure to really get to the point where you know how to do your mix dance. It's not like I can tell you exactly do that, and then your mix sounds good. I mean, I can, and I'm doing that in my mentoring sessions, for example. When you can send me a project file and I go through it and tell you what you could do better to get a better sounding mix or what you can change. But yeah, over remote, just giving like this one tip is really, really hard. It's like a process you have to learn. So yeah, I hope this helps somehow. And yeah, I think that's basically the track. I think we covered everything. Do you guys have any questions? Are there more questions? let me see. I'm just gonna play some background music here. Let me see, that chat is somehow really, really delayed. I hope I'm getting like all the questions in. But let's see. Yeah, did I try to? I think I really covered everything, like I said, on the master. There isn't really anything, at least anything that's doing mix stuff. Let me see, I have a Gold Force going on here. Yeah, this is just for the intro to make it a bit prettier. Let me turn down this music again. So yeah, for the intro there's a Gold Force going on, which is just doing some mix down stuff. So yeah, it's brightening a bit, and it's a really, really cool plugin. Other than that, there's only an Endless Smile, which is doing a little build thing here. And yeah, I have the intro a little bit quieter than the drop, so this gives a lot of impact to the drop. Other than that, there's just this little whack here at the end. And I really have no idea why I have this high cut on here. Normally I don't do that. Maybe the mix was too harsh or something like that, but I would stay away from doing such things on a master. But yeah, it sounds good in this case. But yeah, don't ask me why I did that. Let's see. Yeah, I think it's just cutting off those super harsh frequencies. Yeah, it's probably a bit better for the mix, but yeah, I would try to fix that in the mix normally. Yeah, I think that was pretty much faster than I had planned. Had it planned to be, we only like 1 hour 10 in. I planned like 2 hours for this, but yeah, let's see if you guys have any more questions. By the way, Minion Muse, does the link to the sample pack work now? Did you try it again? I'd say for me, the favorite track of the EP is really, really hard to pick, because these were definitely some of my favorite tracks I've ever made on the Hyper Trap EP. So you guys snagged really some of my best tracks, I think. Yeah, it's really hard to choose. I think for me personally, like, I like Critical Error the least. So Club on the Floor and With The are definitely like one of my favorites. But yeah, really, really hard to pick. talk about your upcoming releases. Really appreciate the answer. It really helps a lot. Yeah, definitely. Sure. Talk about your upcoming releases. So I don't really have a lot going on that I can tell you, at least right now. There's another big label release coming in October, which I can't talk about right now. And yeah, I think October is it's like pretty far away. So yeah, I don't want to tease you guys too much. Other than that, I'm doing a few self releases only with my management, so with Gridlock, releasing through BaseX probably. I have some tracks coming up. Yeah, some of my favorite actually. So Flex is coming up really soon. Let me see. I think I have it in the Banger library here somewhere. Banger collection. Let me see. Yeah, no, this, I've got it. Damn. Oh yeah, here, this one. So Flex is coming up pretty soon. After that one. There we go. Yeah, so pretty excited for that one. It's a pretty old track of mine, but I'm still one of my favorites. So yeah, this is coming up through BaseX pretty soon. And I think PMNA, Pay Me No Attention, is coming up too. Yeah, so I think the next releases are in June. So beginning of June and like mid-June. Like May was pretty... not really easy. That's not even a word. Damn. But yeah, I think you get what I mean. How did you come up with the original idea for the track? Let me see. I must still unfocus again. There we go. The initial idea for the track, that's really hard. I think I started with the drop. Good question, man. There was like no idea. I just started to drop, and then everything came together somehow. So, like I said, I'm trying to don't overcomplicate like my writing process, because I do all the hard work in my sound design sessions, make really really crazy sounds, and then we use them, and that makes a lot of my sound. I think that we use everything I make, and this kind of builds up to your own sound and your own mix down and stuff. And I just tried to came up with a pattern first. So yeah, try to find sounds that work together, try to come up with a pattern, and then backwards worked with the intro and stuff. So one thing I do when I get stuck in a track, I try to reference some tracks. So I told you, for example, I used Get the Fuck Up from Kaiwashi in the build-up. I think even the intro was kind of inspired by this, like he has this string thing going on. I don't want to get you guys a copyright strike. So. But yeah, you can see it's having that kind of stringy orchestral intro too. And I used another one, Snaps, I can feel. Yeah, there were probably some of the percussion elements and stuff in there, but mainly I have them in here for mixing references and stuff. I hope that gave you an idea how I did this. How did you master it though? I forget a question from Aaron. Man, any tip about sound staging? Yeah, I think it's the same tip I told you before, like have only a few elements in the foreground and the rest really in the background. Try to for background stuff, try to EQ it, get rid of some high end, get rid of some low end, and really have it sit in the back. Sometimes reverb can help to push it even further away. Other than that, like I said, really a lot of mixing stuff comes from sidechaining. Have a good sidechain, a good clean sidechain. Have your drums and your sub really, really loud and working together. Like I said, if you only play this part, it really works on its own too. I mean, it's a great foundation. Like it's not a track, but you still get a groove from that, and I think that's really, really important. And I think the most important things for sound staging are EQing and leveling. So only like the levels of your stuff. And I think that's basically it. Sometimes like stereo imaging is like a big part too. But yeah, that's definitely a whole nother topic to talk about. What did I miss? Let's see. But I liked all of those tracks. It was on repeat. Appreciate that, man. How did you master it though? I don't have anything on the master. This is how it comes out. And this is how I do all my masters, basically, like a non-mastered master. Sometimes I have a soft clip on here, but not on this track. Because I'm most of the times just have the feeling that it gets too scratched if I put a soft clipper on there. And Ableton, if you export it, you still have a soft clipping on there, which is applied by Ableton somehow. What would you do for VIP? That's a good question. I actually don't have a VIP, but so I haven't made a VIP yet. Maybe someday I do. But for VIP, I probably would take the original idea, especially the intro and stuff, and just make it more weird or more energetic. Try to resample those sounds I've used, and maybe trying even another genre. Like, for example, if I have this trap track, I maybe try to make a drum bass VIP out of this, or like a house tune or something like this. This would be really, really interesting. Changing the key, maybe changing the BPM, and taking the original idea and transform it into something different. Probably the same way I would work on a remix. And it's not showing check, it's shows Facebook user, that's all. That's weird. Because it's working on my end. Can anyone else try to download that free sample pack I have in the description? It should open up a Facebook Messenger and open up a sequence. But if it doesn't work, I'm gonna give you guys another link to that. Will this stream be achieved? I think so. Would you do a tutorial for club? Yeah, we can definitely set something up for that too. Club is a really, really great track too. But yeah, I have to see if I have everything for this one too. Think I covered all the questions, right? Any more questions? And yeah, this delay is just so big. I'm sorry about that. Let's see if I have something more going on here. I think I've covered everything important. Your mastering is great. Appreciate that. I've over the years I've tried so many different ways of mastering my music, and it's a really begging process for me. And I just find that less is more again. So use a lot of mixing tricks, but not really doing a lot on the master. And just every time I try to put something on my master, it just sounds so weird and different. And Can you suggest some hybrid trap serum packs? Not really, because I'm designing all my sounds myself, but I will come up with some packs. I already showed something here. Drum bass version would be sick. Yeah, definitely. So yeah, like I said, I'm coming up with a pack too. Actually, with the release of my sample pack, which is hopefully coming out this weekend, you guys can get this Hybrid Trap Mastery sample pack, which is having a lot of 808s, and I can show you some stuff here in here. Let me get rid of that low. So that's weird. Let me see. Do I have any processing on here? Yeah, I have a lot of processing on here already. So let's get rid of that. 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 Yeah, this one is a bit weird, but do I have, I think I still have something. Let me open a new instance of Serum here. Just a second, and then I can show you these patches. So you have an idea of what's coming up in the pack. let me see. So, yeah, there are definitely some insane bass sounds in here. Yeah, so I don't want to spoil everything. There are some leads in here too. And yeah, this is definitely like really, really cool stuff in here. And I have everything set up through macros, and even the mod wheel is attached to most of it. Some insane like bass 808s too. Oh shit, that one was loud. Yeah, some beautiful plugs and stuff too. Yeah, other than that, I don't really use preset packs that much. Let me see. Yeah, do I even have a pack in here? I think I have some packs, but yeah. But I'm not really using those. Yeah, so yeah, not really a recommendation on that. Some medics have some good sample packs for it. To search drum kits on Reddit, sample packs link. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, also guys, please make sure again to follow me on my YouTube channel. So I'm streaming there a lot too. So I have this link in the description where you can subscribe to it. This really helps my channel to grow and yeah, putting out a lot more content on it. Did anyone else try that pack? Nah, man, I want only for leads. Yeah, like I said, there are a lot of leads in here too, which you can use, but yeah, other than that, I don't really have an idea on other packs because I design everything myself. Like Nasty. Yeah, I think Nasty has even some packs, but and Godlands. Yeah, can't really help you with that. Sorry. So, any more questions? Otherwise, we probably would wrap it up in a few minutes if you guys don't have anything more to ask. But yeah, really, really enjoyed doing this. Maybe we do another one for club soon. Or maybe I'm doing a tutorial on it. Do you have any shows coming up? No. Because here in Germany, we still have a lot of restrictions when it comes to playing shows and stuff. We still have kind of a lockdown. And yeah, but definitely when clubs are opening up back up again, I try to get some shows. At least here in Germany, I don't know if I can to the US anywhere soon. But yeah, I'm not doing it. I'm not really doing it for playing shows at the moment. I want to get like a bigger audience first. And I think shows will come as an effect of this really, really soon too. I mean, with a big label release, it's like the Hypertrap release with you guys and Subsidio release and some other big labels that are coming up. I think the chance of playing shows is getting bigger, and we will fall in place eventually. How long have you been producing for? I've been producing for 8 years now, probably. But yeah, not all the way through. So I've did some breaks in between. But yes, since 2014, I subbed. Great work. Thank you, man. Appreciate that. And yeah, this the Serum preset pack, you can only get it, I think, if you get my pack, probably. Maybe I do it as a sale another time too, but you can get it as a bonus thing. And yeah, this would be 17, I think, for the preset pack, and the sample pack is more expensive, but yeah, it's a huge library. It's over a thousand sounds, like 1,400 sounds or something like that. The link isn't working. That's too bad. Which one? The one for the sample pack or the one for the sub? Because everything is working on my end. That is so weird. Yeah, I will hit Hypertrap up and change the link to another page then. I thought it should work, but somehow it doesn't, right? Let me see, actually. Yeah, maybe it's because Facebook has some weird stuff going on with the European people. Let me see. Maybe I'm sending you guys another link. Let me know if this one works. Get link. Is this one working? Can you guys try this one out? Maybe that's better. Maybe not. Otherwise, I will send another link to Hypertrap and they update the info. Any more questions, guys? How did you get your name? I've got my name. Yeah, it's kind of like a weird story. It was one of my characters on World of Warcraft, actually, when I played that back in the days. And I think I wanted to name my character in the beginning something like Jack or something like that, because I actually watched a lot of 24 Hours. I don't know if you know that series, that show. It's with Kiefer Sutherland, I think, and I really liked it at that time. I have no idea why. It's kind of weird. Yeah, and then I came up with Jack, and I think it originated from that. So yeah, Jack wasn't available, so I tried to come up with something that kind of pronounced like Jack, and came up with Jack. And yeah, I kind of stuck to that alias, and yeah, it's been long time that I have that name. I thought many times about rebranding, but I think, yeah, I'm gonna stick to it, at least for this genre. Maybe I come up with something new someday. The link just shows one Facebook user. And have you ever used other DAWs? Yeah, that's so weird that this link isn't working. Really, really weird. I don't get it. Like I said, I will get a new link for Hypertrap where you can get the pack. Have you ever used other DAWs? Yeah, I've actually started with Fruity Loops, and I tried many times to get back to Fruity Loops, but I just feel really, really uncomfortable with it. Other than that, I tried. Other than that, I tried the Bitwig one time, but yeah, I just can't use anything else than Ableton. It just feels super weird. Do you ever get the feeling where you've been doing a track for so long and you just wanted to quit? Yeah, actually a lot of times. As a producer, you're always dealing with those kind of thoughts, and yeah, I thought many times about quitting, and once I actually quit it for a long time. So I've had a big break for like 2 years or something like that where I haven't produced. But yeah, I came back to it. And yeah, I think like, especially as a beginning producer, but also as like a more experienced, you always get into phases where you can't get anything down, or yeah, you just feel like you're not making a big progress. But you really have to stick through it. Like someday you will just be like a lot better than you were before. And yeah, I think you just have to stick through it and find your ways of working. That's what helped me a lot. So I'm, like I said, I'm doing, when I'm not feeling like writing, I try to do something other than writing. So I'm trying to do sound design, trying to come up with yeah, new ideas, how to evolve my brand, how to, yeah, maybe make some money as a producer too, because that's like, yeah, someday I want to do this as a full time, but right now I'm working 9 to 5 in another job, but yeah, it's a big dream of mine to someday live from my craft and from my passion, because yeah, that's what I want to do the most time, at least right now. So yeah. I'm not the only one. That's so weird with the link. I'm not the only one. Hello. Hello, El Josh. What's going on, brother? Rapid Noise. What is the biggest show you ever DJed? Unfortunately, I haven't played like a really, really big show. So I started DJing with a friend of mine under another alias, but just as a DJ duo, kind of. And yeah, I think the biggest I ever played was like a little club in a city near to me called Bhutan, which is actually known for a lot of techno shows and stuff here in Germany, at least. But yeah, this club got closed down, and it was not like a big venue. I think there were only like maybe 30 people in the room where I played, but it, yeah, it was definitely a lot of fun, and I'm looking forward to doing more DJ stuff. But I'm not the best DJ, and that's not what I'm focusing on right now. I think when the time comes and shows are being booked and stuff by my management, I have to come up with a better DJ or with better DJ skills. And but yeah, definitely looking forward to playing some more shows. Ableton is good, actually. Just get stuck with it. Yeah, I feel like every DAW is good. Like, I really love a lot of the Fruity Loop stuff too, but I just can't get used to it somehow. There are some things that really weird me up. So yeah, and I just feel like home in Ableton. I know how to do everything. I know every effect. I know, yeah, I just know how to work in there, which I don't actually know a lot in Fruity Loops, or haven't found my workflow in Fruity Loops. But yeah, maybe someday I'm gonna try another DAW again. What is the hardest thing when it comes to producing a song? I think that really differs from song to song. Like, there are some songs where I can't get like a theme down. I think that was one of my biggest, how do you say that? Not errors, but some of the downsides of my production, like don't having like a lot of theme-based stuff. Yeah, or having like the intro sounding too different from the drop. Like, actually, a lot of songwriting, I'd say. Like, that is, for me, the hardest part. But sometimes it really flows out nicely if you have, like, a good idea. And like this, where you have some good pattern going on, then it's kind of falls all together. But I think in every track you have a few things that are hard to get down. Most of the times, a lot of stuff for me, for example, is too bright, so I tend to overbright my mix downs a lot. That's what I try to fix a lot in my newer tracks, having it just more balanced. But yeah, really hard to answer. You're an inspiration. Thank you, Many Muse. I really appreciate that. Started with a good idea, I guess. After that, it's really easy to create a banger. Yeah. It really depends, like, if you have the right sounds, if you have the right mindset, and it depends on so many things. But I think mixdown is like one of the hardest things to get down as a beginner. And then, yeah, a lot of, like, it's almost endless. Like, I'm still learning every single fucking day something new about production. And yeah, it's so weird because I'm doing it for such a long time, and you get the feeling that you know everything, but no, you just scratch the tip of the iceberg. So, who's your favorite producer you've ever collabed with? So I actually haven't collabed with a lot of people, but for me, definitely Vondu is one of the coolest dudes I've collabed with. That was the Subsidiary release, and he actually has a release on Hybrid Trap too, so definitely check him out. Let me search him up. Yeah, and it's just like Vondu and I would just work really, really good together. Like, he's insane with flow and stuff. So yeah, here's the Hybrid Trap release from Vondu. And I really, really dig in his sound, and yeah, I really can tell when it's a Vondu track, and that's what I really appreciate about him. So yeah, collab-wise, probably he would be, like, the best. Other than that, I have some collabs coming up with some bigger people do, but yeah, most of the times they tend to get back really, really slowly to me, and that's what I don't appreciate. With Rondu, like, we can get the track down in a day or two, and that's, yeah, like, one of the best things, I think. Like, we really complement each other really good. And we have another track coming up, actually. Maybe I can show it to you. We haven't found a home for it now, but yeah, I can play you a little bit of it if you guys want to get a sneak peek. Vondu. Let me actually see. Where is it? Yeah, there it is. I'm gonna play you a little. Yeah, so really excited for that one too. It's really cool. Stimulator is a banger. Yeah, definitely. Vondu is an insane producer. I really dig his sound a lot. Will you ever try making other music rather than Hybrid Trap and Heavy Bass? Definitely, definitely. I mean, I do a bunch of stuff outside of drum bass, outside of hybrid trap. So I've made some drum bass tunes, for example. I can preview you something, maybe. Let me see. Where is it? Yeah, for example, here, this is a drum bass track. Make it bounce, 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 bounce. Make it bounce, 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 bounce. Make it bounce. Make it bounce to the floor. Yeah, but probably you still would consider this as heavy bass. So, yeah, maybe someday I try to do something more acoustic. Like, I really love to sing myself too, but I can't get, like, my voice down that good. And I'm really bad at, like, writing lyrics and stuff. Yeah, but I actually have some tracks where I have my own vocals in. Like, for example, Mosh Now, which will come out somewhere soon, probably in the summer. There are my own vocals, but maybe some acoustic music with guitar or something like that, but nothing planned right now. So yeah, here in Mosh Now. When I need moves going wide now, when I hit the bottom with the right floor, when I'm even ready for the shit that's coming up now, I wanna see all the hands in the Mosh Now. Mosh Now. Yeah, but I really try to come up with a lot of vocal stuff, my own, and try to incorporate that more into my music, because I think that's something really unique. That's, for example, what I really love about Fabian Mazur or some people like this, who really, yeah, produce their own vocals, and it's always really, really dope. So, yeah. Song was dope. Appreciate that. Yeah, please, please, please make sure to follow me on my YouTube channel. Because I'm doing a lot more streams on there too. I'm posting the link again here. But it's also in the description, so make sure to follow me there. My subwoofer 10 inch. Let me see. Song was dope. Da-da-da. Name. What's your favorite song you ever made? Oh, that's a really, really tough question. I think actually Mosh Now is one of my favorite, which I just played you. Other than that, ooh, that's really hard. Definitely some of my favorite tracks were in the Club EP. Like, Club is really, really great. It's so hard. Like, I have a lot of tracks and a lot of unreleased tracks going on. So probably Pay Me No Attention would be one of my favorites too. This one. Yeah, but it's not out yet, but definitely one of my favorite. Yeah. Name. What do you mean by name? El Josh. 10-inch LMR would be a weird thing. Eargasmic, though. What's your favorite BPM? Probably 150, because I'm doing a lot of stuff in 150. But I really enjoy those slower trap things, like I did in Critical Error, for example. I think that's like 115 or so, or 110. It was a long time since I've made that track, but but yeah, sometimes it's really, really hard to do those kind of slower trap things. But it's definitely interesting. Also, yeah, 145, 140 is really cool too. But most of the times I'm doing 150 because I'm just like a lazy guy. After that, I probably need a breakdown for this track though. Which track are you talking about? Yeah, any more questions? I mean, there were a lot of great questions. I tried to answer everything as good as I can. Yeah, please make sure to follow Hybrid Trap, follow me on my Instagram, follow me on my YouTube channel on Twitch. I will post a link tree again here just to make sure you get all the links you need. I hope this works. Yeah. Link tree. Yeah, it should work. Yeah, also join my Discord server. There's a lot of stuff coming up for this, hopefully soon. I mean, it's not that active yet, but it's getting more active day in, day out. So hopefully we have a big community soon. Any more questions? Yeah, the delay is really, really hard. So you probably get this like a minute later than I'm saying it. So yeah, let's wait a little bit. But I think we covered everything. Like I said, I'm doing a lot of streams at least once a week. I try to do a stream mainly on the weekend. So if you guys have any more questions on anything, just yeah, come and hang around in there. What city are you in? I'm actually right now in Solingen in Germany. Thank you for streaming. Appreciate that. Yeah, it's been a lot of fun, and I really appreciate to do streams in general. It's just, yeah, like the audience isn't that big right now, and that's kind of demotivating. But I'm seeing new people every now and then in there, and a lot of active people like Awen, for example, is in there all the time. Then Minimuse is a lot in my streams lately, and we have a few people that are, yeah, just really, really active on here, and I appreciate that a lot. And there are some people like that were in there from day one, and that's really cool. Poxer Jonas is like one of my most active ones too, and yeah, a few people. Prakar is really active. Your key tip to get out of a writer's block: not try to force yourself to write something. Actually, try to do something else. Do sound design sessions. Do learn new plugins. Download new packs and search for gems in there. Or sometimes even just a break helps a lot. For example, I haven't produced music for 2 months lately. I've been getting back into it, so I've made 3 new tracks since then. But yeah, I haven't touched the DAW actually for almost 2 months, and this really gives you a refresher. Sometimes you're just not in the mood anymore, your creative juice is just gone, and then this is one of the only ways I know, at least, to, yeah, get it back. But don't try to force yourself too hard on writing something, because that happens every producer, like all the best people, especially in the beginning, you have a lot of ideas and start a lot of new tracks. But when you did a lot of tracks and finished a lot of tracks, you tend to lose the creativeness somehow. And yeah, then breaks are one of the best things to get over it. Bro, I've used FL for my whole life, and now I have just a simple question: how to make bass slides in Ableton? Let's actually open up a blank project here, because this project is really blown off and it's really slow. And yeah, then I'm gonna show you how to make bass slides in Ableton. It really depends on which plugin you use. You use Serum or... In Ableton there is not like a slide function, you just make the notes overlap into each other, and that way you get a glide, but you have to activate the portamento in your synth. So I'm gonna show you that. Can you make a quick beat off the top? Yeah, I can try to. How much time do we have left, actually, Hybrid Trap? I I mean, if you want to see me making stuff from the top, then yeah, come into my streams on my YouTube channel or on my Twitch. I'm doing a lot of tracks from scratch there too. So maybe for an 808. Yeah, let's see. Let's open up a new instance of Serum. What do you use for producing? Is it Serum or, I mean, for sound design? Is it? So in, I can show you in Serum, for example, if you want to make an, let's make a really, really quick 808. Let's make, yeah, something like that. Looks good. Let's just use some bright white and distort the shit out of it. Let's use some filtering here. Yeah, for aerial egg lights, you have to activate the mono here, then a the important thing here is the portamento. So either you can put it to a value, for example, like 150 or something like that, and then just stack another node above it. But yeah, like I said, the really important step here is to make your voicing in mono, because if you have it polyphonic, you can play multiple notes on top of each other, and this way you can't glide. So for example, if I want to make a glide onto the F sharp here, so you can see it's the glide up here. And yeah, then you can change the glide time here. Or you could use the always mode, which is kind of cool sometimes too, to get some movement in there. So this way, oh damn, where is it? This way you don't have to make those notes overlap anymore, but you can still have the glide. Yeah, something like that. And with other things, you can, for example, an operator, it's the same thing. You can turn the voicing here on the under white menu here. When you click on that, you can turn the voicing to one, so it's only mono. And then there is a glide time. I think it's under pitch envelope. Yeah, you have to turn on the glide, and then you can use just one here to make the same stuff. So you can make the same glide stuff. I hope that helped. Yeah, probably not starting a beat on off the top because we only have a few minutes left. But yeah, like I said, join me on my streams, please, on my YouTube channel. Link is down below in the description, and I'm doing a lot of off the top beats and tracks on there. Any more last minute questions here? I think we only have like 4 minutes left for this, so you're welcome. Yeah, it's actually pretty simple, like the actual process when you know how, but it depends on which synth you're using. But this always step also glides everything. Yeah, when you turn it to always, it glides every time, so you can make like single notes. So I tend to use the not gliding mode and overlap the notes when I do glides. What do you like to do for fun? Yeah, actually right now I'm not doing anything for fun. I think you mean like activities, right? I mean, because of Corona or COVID, we are all kind of locked in and can't do stuff that makes us fun, but definitely watching like episodes with my girlfriend in the evening is one of the things that really gets me down. Other than that, when everything reopens, I really like to boulder. So it's like climbing, but on jumping height. That's something I like to do. Other than that, yeah, meeting with friends, drinking, DJing. Actually, I haven't been drinking like too much lately, and I'm kind of glad that I didn't, because I'm really not a guy that is good on alcohol. So, but yeah, sometimes it needs to be. How to drink some delicious water? Yeah, you have to. I'm gonna show it. Quick tutorial here. So you take your glass, you fill it up with fucking water, and then you drink it. Shit. But yeah, it's that easy. No jokes. Hope everyone is safe. Yeah, I hope too. Who is your greatest influences? Yeah, probably Nasty was one of my biggest influences back then. Yeah, like all the big trap people, like Nasty, Boombox Cartel, Fabian Mazur, Snaffs. Yeah, really, really digging all those kind of things. Who's your greatest influence? How do you prefer doing 808s and Serum than using a sample? It's so uncomfortable that Ableton doesn't have this simple function with slides. I mean, for me it's simple because I'm not used to anything else, but yeah, you just have to get used to it, I think. Yeah, I really use. Another cool thing is SupLab. I don't know if you ever heard of that. Can get some neat stuff out of this too. Here are some really, really cool things in here, and you can use your own samples even, and some really cool distortion modules. Can get some really, really crazy stuff out of this. But yeah, most of the times I'm just using Serum. And yeah, like I showed in this breakdown, Trash 2. I'm from India. Where are you from? I'm from Germany. Sounds so ironic. What do you mean with the glass of water or what? That's not ironic. That's SupLab looks crazy. I think it's something like $30. Let me see. And it's on sale every now and then too. SupLab. SupLab is $40 right now. Special price for early adopters. Yeah, but I think it's on sale sometimes too. But yeah, $40 is pretty cool. How much is it? Yeah, that was the question. Both actually. I usually make my stuff and render it out as audio and then do some crazy post-processing. Yeah. Interesting thing. Definitely, definitely. I know you're from India, yeah, but the questions are really delayed. I thought you asked me where I come from. I mean, you know where I come from, but yeah. Any more questions? I am India. You are India. You are pretty big then. Yeah, many, many Indian people are actually watching me. That's really interesting. Yes, man, you are India. I don't know. Any more questions? Do you you do your own vocals? Yeah, most of the times I try to. To be honest, with my new mic, with the Shure SM7B, I try to do some vocals, but I'm not used yet to the sound of it. The old one, the AT2020 from I don't know where I have it actually. From Audio Technica. I've made a lot of my own vocals with that, but yeah, I still have to get used to it. And for example, in my new sample pack, I have a lot of samples in here too. Gangster. Yeah, so these are all like my pack, my vocals, my voice. I appreciate that. Thank you, man. Whispack from Russia. Wow, I haven't got like someone from Russia in here. That's cool. Yeah, please make sure to follow me on my YouTube channel. Shameless self plug again, but yeah, would love to see you guys around on my streams too, because it's a lot more fun when people ask questions and stuff. When do clubs open in Germany? I have no idea if they ever we open. Probably all the clubs are gone when COVID is gone. Like, I don't know. It's a really, really tough time. And I hope they reopen soon. But yeah, I can think about any scenario that's happening soon. I mean, as soon as something reopens, somehow the numbers go up again, and that's like a really bad thing. Guten Tag, Jack. Guten Tag. Wie geht's dir? We all fam. Mara, Russia. Yes, I was attending class. Thank me for 2 hours. Yeah, really appreciate that you guys hang around here. Who is your dream collab? Probably Nasty. Nasty, Fabian Mazur, Boombox Cartel, like all the big people I talked about as my inspiration. But yeah, maybe someday I do a track with Nasty. We've been writing a bunch, and he's really digging my stuff too. And yeah, that would definitely be one of my goals. But I think he's stepping back a bit from doing that hybrid trap stuff, unfortunately. But maybe he comes back soon. Hybrid trap friends all, me and you. Are you vaccinated? Vexed? Not yet. I'm post-COVID, but I have my vaccination on Friday. So yeah, best of luck for that. I've had COVID back in end November, beginning of December, till the end of December, and yeah, in Germany here's the Robert Koch Institute, which is like a health organization, and they recommend to get your vaccination 6 months post-COVID. So, yeah. Hit that like button. Yeah, smash that fucking like button. And, yeah. love you too. Much love, guys, for joining the stream, for being that active. 8 people still watching. That's cool. Yeah, any more questions? I mean, we're 2 hours in, and that was the goal, so... And I really need to visit the toilet really soon, so... Please, everyone, also make sure to join my Discord server. I'm posting a link in here. Let me see. There we go. Yeah, please make sure to join my Discord server to hang out with me, to write with me, to next stream tomorrow. I'm working tomorrow, but probably Saturday or something like that. I will keep you guys updated with that. Also, I'm trying to be more active on my socials now too, like posting stuff regularly to Instagram, and yeah, I have to come up with Twitter and all that too, but I have no idea what to say on Twitter. Welcome back, Black Lyre. We're almost out, but yeah, please again make sure to follow me on YouTube so you can hang with me on my next stream, probably Saturday. Yeah, so No Voice Man, you can rewatch it later. Sure, I'm gonna send my beat. Yeah, we can do a feedback session too if you guys want to. We can discuss this in the Discord server maybe. When you join the Discord server. Appreciate that, yeah. Appreciate the chance to stream on the Hyper Trap channel. Was really stoked that you guys asked me. I mean, really stoked on our release, and I think like the club EP is really, really big. And yeah, happy to show you guys how, let you guys in my brain and see how I work. Okay, that's great. Sure, I'm gonna send my beat. Yeah. Yeah. Appreciate those words. Like I said, I really love to do streams and show my process and stuff. So yeah, it's a win-win for everyone. Join the Discord server, fam. Self plug. Apple phone. iPhone. You're on your iPhone. Man, the stream is so delayed, that's so weird. Like, I'm seeing stuff I can't even remember doing, like the heart thing right now, so that was like 2 minutes ago, which is weird. Yeah, appreciate that, and leave a follow on YouTube too. Like I said, I'm not that active yet on Instagram. I try to post stuff regularly now, but definitely more active on YouTube, and I really try to come up with some tutorials really soon too. I recorded some, but I have to edit some, and that's like the most begging process. Do a beatbox. Yeah, that's all I can. Maybe some bass sounds too. Yeah, sometimes it's really, really cool to beatbox your ideas down. That's what when I come up with a sick idea, I try to save that as a beatbox and try to work with that. talent. what kind of headphones are you wearing? Yeah, really expensive ones. Those are the Focal Clears. I wanted to invest in something that is more like a monitor, and those are open back headphones, really, really good open back headphones. And yeah, I've made the step into investing in those. Still have to get used to them. Like, to be honest, the step from the Audio Technica to those weren't that big, but yeah, I think if I get used to it and maybe get another preamp, they are even getting better. Next time Jack is going to make Fart Trap. Yeah, I try to. Yeah, they are. I think maybe for TikTok we can make a Fart Trap beat kind of thing. Awesome. Yeah, they are very, very expensive. And really good, but still have to get used to open back and all that. Can you review this for sure? Let's see. Holy shit. Damn. I have to snag that one. Dude, this is insane. What the fuck? Damn. I love the flow. Yeah, I would love to throw a remix for that. I mean, if you can contact Nocta for me, it would be cool. Definitely digging the first drop more, but second drop is cool too, but I think mixing wise the first drop was way better. But I really love his percussion work and stuff. It's insane, especially like the first drop, and like the percussions right here in the intro were dang so vibey. How the fuck? So what are we, maybe we can work on some stuff for Hybrid Trap together, Nocta, if you're seeing this. So one question, your entire track sounds non-copyright. I have no idea. I think they are copyrighted, but yeah, I mean they are distributed, so probably they are copyrighted. I'm actually not sure if you can use my tracks in vlogs. I don't know what happens if they get striked or something like that. I don't want you guys to get striked because of me, but yeah, I think if you tag me and stuff, that should be okay. I don't know. Yeah, really, really great. He has dropped an EP on your label, right? What else is there? Really ate Adlian's wipe here. collab would be sick for sure. Yeah, definitely. Hybrid Trap, in a year, I'll be making good tracks for your channel. Remember me and note this, okay? Thank you, bro. Love from India. Yeah, love back. Please again, make sure to follow me on my socials, on my YouTube again. So I would love to see all you guys around on my streams. Yeah, that's cool too. I just feel like Mantra is like next level shit. He's from Spain, actually. That's cool. I have to check out his other stuff too. Lamento. Mick, Mike, what joke? Mini Muse is dropping bars. Mit dem Banger. This is wipe. Yeah, I think we are going to. Damn, another comment. This is insane. Keep up the heat. How do I get that? Give me that. Connect. Yeah, other than that, I think I'm gonna kill the stream now, because I really need to go to the toilet. Super Ave Creep has some sick vocal cuts, if anyone's heard it. I haven't heard it, but definitely check it out after the stream. Yeah, any last minute questions? Other than that, I would cut up the stream here. Jackie Chan is here. Is this the original Jackie Chan though? Yo, Jackie Chan, make sure to follow me on YouTube, by the way. Streaming weekly and stuff. The track be like, yes, you need to go off the toilet. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna cut it here. Thanks again, everyone, for joining the stream and for such an interactive stream. Was a lot of fun. A lot of great questions in here. I hope you guys learned something from the stream. And yeah, I would really, really appreciate it if you follow me on my socials again, on YouTube, on my Discord server, on Instagram, on Spotify. And yeah, just stay up to date with my brand and with my streams and all that. Like I said, I'm doing streams weekly at least. I try to do weekly streams. I try to upload more videos to YouTube really soon. And yeah, hopefully on this weekend my sample pack will drop. So if so, maybe Hybrid Trap will link it down below in the description. And yeah, really, really appreciate all the love in here. And hopefully we see us in my streams. Any last questions? No. Thanks for your stream. Please reply. Reply to what? Let me see. What was the question? Can we see you again soon, fame? Yo, Paul. Appreciate that. Black Liar. I think you asked that with a non-copyright, right? I can't really answer you that. I mean, our stuff is distributed. Maybe Hybrid Trap can give you an answer to that, but I think if you use the track in one of your videos, you at least can monetize it. I don't know if you get striked too. Yeah, really can't answer that. Yeah, thanks Cyber Trap for letting me stream on your channel. Yeah, again, really appreciate that. And I think we have all something from that. So also, if you haven't checked out the Club EP, which I broke down one track of it, make sure to listen to it, comment to it, especially listen to it on Spotify. I think there needs to be some more movement in there. Not movement, what am I talking even? Yeah, I'm posting the Club EP in the comments right now, so you guys can check it out. But yeah, was a lot of fun. I'm heading out. Talk to you soon and see you hopefully in my streams somewhere. Let me go to the cam only thing. And yeah.